here talking to Dan N. Green. He's a former fighter. He's a famous stand-up comedian. You may have seen him in a commercial on your TV. But also, Dan N. Green has just produced a documentary, a one-of-a-kind documentary, and I just watched it, about a boxing gym in Philly that their nickname, and you'll be surprised to hear this, the nickname of the gym was the Executioners.
Yes.
And you were one of the executioners.
I was one of the executioners, yes, sir.
So, Dan, first of all, very impressed with the documentary, how you flew to everyone's house, how you met with people. And I don't think any gym where you could, right now in gyms, where you could go back 30 years and bring back all the fighters and coaches and referees to talk about those days. It would be impossible to do. It's one of a kind. Tell us about that.
Well, you're absolutely right. It's going to be, it's the first boxing.
It's a boxing gym in Philly, West Philly,
yes,
by the way.
Yes, it's a boxing documentary called The Executioners that was created in 1974. This is the first boxing documentary of its kind anywhere, because there's never been a boxing documentary about a team.
About a gym.
So he's
about
a
superstar, a legend.
Yes, and the thing about it, what I mean by that is, you had the Kronk, you had some of the other gyms, but they would have guys that already would have been boxing coming to the gym to train under Emmanuel Stewart.
Correct.
This was the first gym.
May champions, I guess.
Homegrown. Every single fighter was 0-0 before they got to the gym.
So for those watching, West Philly, we all know from the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, West Philly born and raised,
okay,
and
getting shook
in a basketball court.
Yeah, yeah.
What was it like for you as a kid, for the other guys in the gym?
It was a very rough area.
What does that mean, rough?
Well, what I mean by is rough is, you know, Philadelphia wasn't big on gangs. The gangs period, it was big on gangs, but at that time, it was ending 75, 76, the Muslims, the Muslim religion, help get the boys from stop gang war. So, but Philadelphia then became an area of neighborhoods. So like for you to walk through one neighborhood, it would be like, you know, even 4 or 5 blocks from your house, you may have to be on your P's and Q's at all time because dudes would be testing you. So
it wasn't blacks and Mexicans, it was straight black.
Because black.
But why would you attack someone who looks like you, talks like you, dresses like you?
Ellie, they ain't got nothing to do with nothing, bro. Philadelphia is a city.
Same religion.
Yeah, it was the same in the black neighborhoods as it was in the white neighborhoods. The white north neighborhoods in Philadelphia, the Northeast, they had their situations, and it would be white on white, Italians against Italians, whatever. But if black people would go down to like South Philly at that time, then they would catch the heat. That's where the Italians and stuff were.
So your gym.
My gym.
The two dudes, I saw them in the videos. What are their names?
Marvin Tucci Gordon and Frank Taylor.
They established a gym in a very bad area.
Yes.
And how much did it cost you guys to train there? Do you remember?
I think it was $5 a month or what, but it felt like it was $100 back then. Because, you know what I mean?
You know, how did you afford it back then as a kid?
We really couldn't. You know, okay. It was really done from them. And that's another thing that people don't understand. These guys really started the gym, and it was all out of their own pockets. When we traveled with them, we went around the country.
They paid for everything?
They paid really, You know, your mom back then would give you $20 for travel, but your parents didn't have hotel money and gas money to give, you know. So it was really a labor of love for them. Nothing given by the city or anything.
What do you want the people who are going to watch this documentary, The Executioners by Dan N. Green, what do you want them to take away from this?
It's a very unique story. One of the reasons I want to tell the story is because when people hear The Executioners, they think Bernard Hopkins. And this is not a slight on Bernard, but the first... He's a legend. But these guys, as you can see, and you heard him speak, they were the executioners. And Bernard called himself the executioner. So it was two different, you know. So the documentary is not based on him or really about him, but there is snippets in there about
He's from Philly, too.
He's from Philly. And we beat him twice in the amateurs.
I know him personally. He's a great dude.
Great dude. I met B-Hop. And I want to put this out there. I tried to, you know, and we put it in a doc. I tried to contact him. I tried to get in touch with him. I wanted him to do an interview because I do know him. And his people, for some reason or another, either they didn't get in touch with him or they didn't let him know. So, you know, the show must go on.
Now, where is boxing in Philly stand today? You just had a young fighter from Philly,
J-Rock? J-Rock, who
William
I met.
Williams?
Yeah, I met him
last... He just won a championship?
Yeah, I met him last week. I met him last week. And when I told him about my documentary, he was like, yeah, I heard about that gym. So it was really, it touched me because it let me know that I'm heading down the right direction with the documentary. And Philly's back. Philly and boxing as a whole.
Danny Garcia.
Malik Scott. Yeah, so I think...
A lot of fighters.
Yeah, so it's a story, man. But these are guys that were...
Tevin Farmer.
Ellie, these are guys that had it. And right when they were about to go pro and make something out of them lives, things happened. So I won't tell you about the story, but we had guys that lost their career because two got shot, drugs, religion, everything, man. It's an amazing story.
Why did you all guys get into boxing? Because you used to fight on the street, like they said in a documentary, and that was just the organized
A lot of time, boxing, which is, and also me mentioning about it, that you brought up something very good to talk about. You know, talk about what was the issue and why would people want to get involved with boxing. It's actually in the documentary where it was a place for kids to go. It was a safe haven, and boys would go there. And then if you boxed, people in Philly didn't really challenge you, and they didn't disrespect you. It was like they looked at you as, yo, you really trying to do something with your life. So they would be supportive. That's why boxing got big in Philly.
How much did boxing help you in a stand-up career? Because being a boxer is a lot like being a stand-up comic. It's one person on stage.
And
you either bomb or you succeed. There's no...
It helps me. Boxing has really saved my life. It helped me. It really is, because I've met great people. I've been involved with boxing. I've trained people. It's helped me make money with my career, even though I'm a stand-up comic. And I will say that one time I was on stage, and back in the 90s, early 90s, when I first started doing comedy, and this white guy called me a nigger on stage, and I lost it. And I pretty much knocked him out. But I won't do that again. Yeah, you know. But man, Ellie, man, it's just... I'm happy you saw the documentary.
That's the funniest way of how boxing helped you.
I
didn't mean like how did boxing help you.
Knocking the motherfucker out. My bad. Oh.
But I got it.
Okay, it's discipline. Boxing is discipline. You know what I mean? And I think
you learn to continue even when you fail.
And I really think that it's discipline in the aspect of it helps you after boxing.
That's
you know what I mean? It helps you after in life.
Where could people find the documentary? Where could people keep
well,
up with
we,
you?
Well, right now, we're finishing up the last touches of the documentary. The documentary will be done probably by the middle of June. We've been working on it for over 2 years. It's almost completed. We just did the sound on it.
You flew all over the United States.
I flew all over the country.
I went
to North Carolina, New York.
I saw that.
Back to L.A. I went all
everywhere.
Over the country.
Calabasas.
Everywhere. Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, it's a unique boxing documentary for not only boxers, but for people.
Where is your social media for those who want to follow you?
Follow me. My name is Dannon Green. Dannon, D-A-N-N-O-N, Green 66. And that's my Instagram. And then Dannon Green is my Facebook. And I don't tweet yet, but as we get more and more, you'll be able to go to my website, which is Dannon Green, and we'll be having stuff on it.
Dannon, greatest fighter in history of Philly?
The most popular fighter was Joe Frazier. Joe Frazier. And then it comes down to Tyrone Everett, Matthew Saad Muhammad, or my man, the bald head brother, the middleweight that beat Marvin Hagler. Benny Briscoe. And then we also have Boogaloo Watts.
His son is a great trainer. He trained Gabe Rosado.
Okay, I didn't know that. Yeah.
Yeah.
And then we have Boogaloo Watts. Oh, and that's good. So that'd be great because his dad's picture is in my documentary and his name.
There you have it. Stay tuned right here.
And ladies and gentlemen, follow me, man. Appreciate it.
All right. Stay tuned right here. For YouTubeReport.com, I'm Ellie Secback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter @Secback. And you can follow me on Instagram @Ellie Secback.